Hello, thank you for tuning in to today's edition of A Treasury of Daily Prayer. Before we begin our devotion, just a reminder that today is Maundy Thursday. We will be having our live stream worship tonight at 7 p.m. You'll be able to catch us on YouTube, on this same YouTube channel. Just look for the live stream option. We will be having a unique service tonight since we won't be partaking in the sacrament, but this holiday today focuses on the sacrament. It's going to be quite different, but we will be focusing on the message and focusing on the meaning and the importance of Holy Communion, and it is a good thing to desire it. Tomorrow at 7 p.m., we will be live streaming our Good Friday service. For both services, if you do not have hymnals at home, I do post up the hymns on our YouTube channel, or not our YouTube channel, on our Facebook page. You can download those and print those off for yourselves if you care to use them. We'll be using the page 15 service as for our live streaming services. And then that brings us to Easter Sunday. We will be celebrating Easter Sunday worship with a live stream at 10:30 a.m. Also, please check out our church Facebook page for a supplement to our Easter worship at 6 p.m. Our Wisconsin Evangelical Lutheran Synod will be live streaming a synod-wide live stream worship, giving up all of us like-minded believers an opportunity to worship together and celebrate the resurrection of our Lord. With all that news being given to you, we'll begin our devotion for this Maundy Thursday. Once again, continuing a series of devotions I was given an assignment on to write for the meditations booklet next year. I just found these psalms or these devotions based on Psalm 42 are so appropriate for what we're going through with this pandemic. Once again, our devotions are under the theme, Why Are You Depressed? And our scripture lesson for today is Psalm 42, verses 7 and 8. Deep calls to deep in the roar of your rapids. All your breakers and your waves have swept over me. Day by day, the Lord commands his mercy, and at night, his song is with me, a prayer to the God of my life. This is God's word. The title for our devotion is The Lord Commands His Mercy. School was out and summer vacation arrived as Michael looked forward to his first Bible camp. The lake, canoes, swimming, and camping all had their appeal. However, Michael had never been away from his family. Fun turned to apprehension as evening approached. Tears filled his eyes as he lay in his bed. Quickly, he asked to call his parents. Despite all the encouragement from Mom and Dad, he couldn't be convinced to stay. Dad came to bring Michael home. Homesickness. Our psalmist experienced this feeling as he was separated from his homeland and temple. Guilt and apprehension overwhelmed him in a new land, so he cried out to the Lord, much like the prophet Jonah cried from the belly of the fish when he said, "You threw me into the depths, into the heart of the seas. The currents swept over me. I said, I have been driven away from your sight. Nevertheless, I will once again look toward your holy temple." Jonah chapter 2, verses 3 and 4. Jonah and our psalmist had hit rock bottom. Overwhelming emotion rushed over them. Countless questions plagued their minds. Can you relate? Your world is falling apart, and the question arises, why do bad things happen to good people? Why me? But our question is faulty. There is no such thing as a good person. Jesus himself says, no one is good except one, God. Mark 10, verse 17. None of us deserve to have good things happen to us. We all deserve misery and hell. So, is this all there is? The psalmist gives the answer. By day, the Lord commands his mercy, and at night, his song is with me, a prayer to the God of my life. The word mercy is the most common term for God's grace in the Psalms. Mercy is only received through faith in our Lord Jesus. Mercy is freely given through the means of grace in our worship, confession, forgiveness, the preaching of the word, and Holy Communion. When separated from home, family, and friends, nothing is better than a homecoming. When feeling separated from God and his comfort, nothing is better than coming to his house. Flee to God's mercy. Bask in the love of Christ that never leaves or forsakes. Let us pray. Grace all our work shall crown through everlasting days. The heavenly home God gives his own shall echo with our praise. Amen. Once again, thank you for tuning in to our episode of A Treasury of Daily Prayer today. Tune in tomorrow. God bless you as we begin our three-day journey on Holy Week, Maundy Thursday, Good Friday, culminating in the glorious victory of Jesus at the empty grave.